It should be remembered that it is a fundamental law and a full development that any life can only be about that. Possession of the varying attributes of consciousness from that of the atom up to the consciousness of a solar logos is the result of long cycles of acquirement. The solar pitris, therefore, can give to man his consciousness, the lunar pitris can give to him the instinctual consciousness of his vehicle. In there, aggregating in all the kingdoms of nature, on this planet and elsewhere, we use the planetary logos as the solar logos of some total of the form consciousness of their respective bodies. This is the case in every scheme in the system, but in the Earth chain a peculiar condition of affairs was brought about through the planetary. Being here coincident with the moon chain, this is the cause of the present balancing of forces on this chain. The fourth chain in every scheme sees the work of the solar pitris in connection with man begun. It sees also the pitris of his chiefs in activity through the impulse given by the solar angel. The matter of those chiefs has passed through three chains and three realms and is vibrant to a note which is true to the word is. Otherwise, the third can be clearly sounded, and is followed naturally by the fifth, or the dominant. The simultaneous sounding of the third and the fifth, basing it upon the planetary keynote, produces the effect of a threefold chord, or a fourth tone, a complex sound. I am here dealing with the chord of the human hierarchy as a whole. Within the hierarchy there is again diversity, based upon the hierarchical chord, and this produces the many egoic chords and notes, these produced in their turn objective manifestations. We can now trace the progress of egoic energy as it passes down from the abstract levels to the permanent atom. On each plane the work is threefold, and might be tabulated as follows. 1. The response within the permanent atom to the vibration set up by the solar pitris, the worded other. 782. ATRE-ACISE on cosmic fire. 5. The response of the highest group of lunar pitris to the chord of the ego. This definitely affects the spirulia of the atom, according to the stage of evolution of the ego concern. 2. The response of the substance to the atomic vibration upon the particular plane involved. This concerns the second group of pitris, whose function it is to gather together the substance attuned to any particular plane, and to aggregate it around the permanent atom. They work under the law of magnetic attraction, and are the attractive energy of the permanent atom. On a tiny scale each permanent atom has, the substance of a man's chief, a position relative to that which the physical sun holds to the substance of the system. It is the nucleus of attractive force. 3. The response of the negative substance concerned in its molding into the desired form through the dual energy of the two higher groups of pitris. Some thought of the unity of this threefold work has been given in the differentiation of the substance of any plane into A, B, C, atomic substance, molecular substance, elemental essence. This differentiation is not entirely accurate, one aspect is the